gentlemen, it is the wonderful Mr. Peter Kay, ladies and gentlemen. Here he is. Come on out, Peter. Well, let me help you here. You say you've got extra
room? Well, you sit.
Well, you sit here.
I've got a book out. I've got a book out. And the book company made me wear this.
They didn't make you wear
it. No.
How did they make you?
I signed a thing. I'm at the shopping centre tomorrow.
Wearing that? You've got to do.
You've got to do now. I've got a book out.
You've got to wear it like that all around town.
I've got to do the plug, haven't I?
The book's
You've got a book out and all, haven't you?
Yeah, but I'm not wearing it on my head.
Because it's your show, isn't it, dickhead?
That's true.
There you go, pull it, mate. There you go, don't let anyone get a swear word, darling.
How are you? You look very well. It's lovely to see you.
I'll
tell you what I am. And there's the book itself.
Oh, OK. Well, listen. Peter, what's this? You've come on with presents and stuff. I like this.
There you go, a little gift for you, Jonathan.
This could be. Can I open it now?
Yeah, if you want to kill some time.
Okay. I don't need to kill time. We've got great guests waiting to come on, but it's a. Okay. I mean, you're here. You're okay.
I like that. Love that. Done that myself.
What is it?
Sure, it's a camera. There you go. Cross-stitch.
Cross-stitch of what? Of you?
With my face. Put that on your desk. Don't be ungrateful. Christ almighty.
What are you doing now?
I'm messing your continuity up. That's what I'm doing.
Well, we can't...
We
can't edit this out. Are you going to...
Because every time I come on one of your shows, it's always edited about you. It's always cut. Everything's cut. All the songs go. I do songs and everything. They all get cut out. I mess about comedy, but it's all about what's funny for Jonathan. Well,
Peter, I hadn't realised you were so busy. Do that song you do with the moustache. Do that go compare thing.
You're proud of that, aren't you?
I am.
You're proud of that.
Albion.
What, you've got a lot of moustaches there?
Yeah, we've got a lot of
you've
time.
You've prepared for a whole evening.
So how are you then? You like your new show?
Don't keep changing your moustache. How come we can't... People won't know what's going on.
Of course they will.
I was trying to build something. You jumped right in with your props
you
and
what?
Said...
Hey, water?
Shut up, Ross. Listen. What I was going to ask you was...
Go on.
Is, at home...
Yeah?
Does your wife enjoy your material? Do you make the jokes for her?
No, you know it's not funny anymore. I'm not funny at home, am I? Miserable at home.
You're not really miserable.
Give us that. I'm getting my sticky bit off the thing. Go on. Ooh. That thirsty.
Yeah.
I had gammon for tea.
So do you try out material at home? Do you try it out on your wife?
No.
So when a joke occurs to you, you just store it or...
Go on. Do it again.
Could I have one
no,
more?
No, you can't.
Just come one
on.
More.
I'm making a mockery of you, man. Come on. Let's do. Remember what? You're not asking me a question.
I just did, but you were too busy sticking a fake moustache on to listen.
I don't do jokes at all. No.
But I know, but what do you really like, though? I don't know what you really like. You've never invited me round your house. I've invited you round my house. You've never invited me round your house.
You've never. I've never been round. Don't. Oh, I get that.
Where are you going?
Just having a look round. It'll all get edited out anyway.
You've seen London before.
You don't get booked. Don't push round to me.
Come and sit down.
No, I'm going to have a look round. Go on.
Where are you going?
I want to see what's behind here. I'm doing it. Oh. Right. Go on.
Where's he gone now? You've ruined the whole illusion of this.
Go on, talk to me. Talk to me. God, it's freezing. It's freezing. Go on. This is nice. Go on.
You know what's nice is, though, we're paying for it. We might as well use it
You might as well use it.
We might as well.
You're more than welcome to come to my house. It's windy. You're more than welcome to come.
But no, I want to know
what you're... Come and do a bit of cross stitch.
I want to know what you actually
You want to know what makes the comedian. You want to get the tears down.
No, I want to know what you're like as a person, because I see you, like everyone sees you, being very funny on shows.
Are you shouting?
Because I'm worried about the wind. Do you look after yourself? I mean, we can see you.
What do you mean?
Well, do you...
Hey, I'll tell you what, I can hang outside of a building.
Well, look, OK, you're not like... We look at Hugh Jackman, you know, you see a man in his physical prime of
look
life.
At him.
And Stephen, I know you walk,
there's a lot
you
of
keep
walking.
Yourself in shape. Do you... Are you worried about your health? Do you keep in shape?
What kind of a question, Zuma? What are you doing?
I want you to be around for a while. I don't want you to cark it and keel over one day. So
I think I'm all right. Maybe this will be my last interview.
Do you
know, if I let go, it will be.
No! Don't encourage it. This has gone far enough.
It's all right.
This is like a very...
It's okay, everybody in that building. Don't worry. He's got you.
You know what this is? This is if Ken Loach directed King Kong, this is what you'd get.
Ken Loach is diehard. That's what this is.
Peter, we're going to take a break. Can you hang on?
Yeah, I'll be here.
Okay,
see you,
don't go away. We'll be back with more Peter Kay after this. Gentlemen, I'm here with Peter Kay. We've calmed down, we've got him back in from the window, he was hanging on. Peter, I want to show a clip, because there's something you did for the last Comic Relief, which was fabulous. You always do things, it was unexpected, but you always do something, you take it about as far as you can, I guess. You with Susan Boyle was a tremendous moment. Did you see that on Comic Relief? How did you get her to do it? Did you go to her director? Did you have to persuade her, or was she up for it to begin with?
Yeah, she were up for it, yeah. Had a bit of a, going through Simon Cowell and all that, getting his approval. I think he were like, what is going on? This lady makes me a lot of money.
Yeah, he looks after everyone.
Do not ruin it.
And she was, but it was the funny joke. You had to make sure that she was ready to join.
I told her about it. She's up for anything. Eh? She's a good laugh. She's fantastic. Fantastic singer. And we treated it all completely serious. If you go on YouTube and see the proper video, we copied it, and therein lies the humour.
And it's from Chess, isn't it? It was from
Chess.
Okay, let's have a look.
We wanted to do one night in Bangkok, but she couldn't kick her legs.
Okay, here we go. This is Peter Kay with Susan Boyle from Comic Relief. Look at this. I don't think you're a cross-dresser, but you like dressing up for comedy, don't you?
I like doing characters. I'm very lucky because I've been able to do things as me and then do Brian Potter and do Max and Geraldine, and I'd like to go back and do some character things next. It's been really good because I keep people guessing, and I just like doing different things. If a good idea comes along... Them Comic Relief things and Children in Need, the one I did, the animation thing,
which must have taken years.
Yeah, 2 years. But if you get a really good idea, the good thing about doing anything for charity is that you get through a lot of red tape. Mm. So you can do things that you would normally not be able to do because it's... Like, if I went to Simon Cowell and said, I want to do a video with Susan Boyle, I'd be like, get out of town. But I'm doing it for Comic Relief. Oh, yeah, you can. You can do all you want to do. You know, you can ask a lot of people to do things. And then you make a lot of money and it keeps, you know, something funny.
What's your idea for the next Comic Relief?
Go on.
We were in sync then for a minute.
Yeah, we're just...
I can't cross my leg like that. I've got very, very tight upper thighs.
This isn't my leg. Go on.
What do you have planned next for Comic Relief? Have you got an idea on the back burner, or would you not want to share with us? Or
Comic Relief?
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I think I'm just going to do nothing for a while. I've been on tour for 2 years.
Well, the tour has been just a remarkable success. I know you're popular, but you must have been... you must have been surprised by the number of tickets you sold.
It's been amazing. But it's been good because I've been able to be at home and be around the family. I've scheduled it in a way that I do it and then I get back. So it's been really good. So it's been 2 years and I finish in... few. I'm doing back on 4 weeks now. Let me just tell you this. The last night of the tour, sorry, tour, I'm down south, it's in Manchester Arena, and I'm doing it for the Christie Cancer Hospital.
Oh, that's lovely.
So that's the last night of the tour, and the tickets go on sale tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. If you want to get
your tickets, if you go what, to go to a website online, your website.
You can go to mine, get onto internet.
Okay.
www.peterk.co.uk. There you go.
Hey.
And you can get tickets, and it's for the Christie Cancer Hospital. That's the last night.
And all new material.
All new, John. Everything's new. Spring collection.
Okay. are you going to do Phoenix Nights again? Would you go back to the old characters? Will you do more with Geraldine? Or are you always looking forward?
I'm going to do something completely different. I like doing things that I've never... Things, you know what, it's that whole thing. If something scares you, you should do it. But the thing is, it's just, how childish.
I was ready for that.
How childish.
See, you were going to do something.
No, you say, come, you can read. The thing is, I'd like to do, I think, too quick.
If someone's just tuned in, what kind of quality is people, two blokes going,
They'd love this in Czechoslovakia.
Okay, yeah, but you've got no plans to go back any old. Because I was thinking.
Why are you rushing? Slow down. Breathe.
I was thinking. I know, that's beautiful.
Take that home.
No. I was thinking I would like to see a Phoenix Knight movie.
Yeah, they've asked me because it's in between his ones done well.
Huge.
Yeah. I have actually written a full series of Phoenix Knights 3. I've written a screenplay for Phoenix Knight. There he is.
There's Brian. Okay, I'm going to confess something now, which I think I might have told you, I don't know, but when I saw you, and this probably says more about me than you, but as you know, that's the way I like it.
It's about your rash.
No. Okay. I thought you were quite sexist, Geraldine.
So did I, which was freaky for me. I know. Actually, better looking as Geraldine than I am.
You were
as
quite
me.
A comely lass. I thought you were quite a good-looking girl. A comely lass.
A comely lass.
Yeah. Did your wife enjoy seeing you?
Not at all. Why would you? How could you? Not at all. Very freaky. I've still got the breasts in the wardrobe.
Hanging or are they just on a shelf?
They're in a box.
Yeah.
But. Anyway.
So you never put it on as a treat for like on a date night or something.
Go easy on them crisps, Stephen. Save me some.
Peter, what
are you talking to?
Yes, you. You know I'm talking to you.
Someone said yes, okay.
They said to me.
Get him off. I'm going. That's me, though.
No!
Because I hate the bit when you wrap it up.
No, don't be like that.
You always. It's like how you tie it all up. You're not good at that. You've never been good at that. You're not going to.
Subject myself to this.
Well, it's only every 2 years, isn't it? I never do any telly.
I know, but come on, just come on and be nice.
But no, one more thing, right?
Yeah.
When I'm...
Damn it. Damn it. Oh, he's down. Look up. Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Kay. Yeah. We've got to take a break, don't go away. We'll be back with Stephen Fry.